just how much God loved us. You know, when you really think about the fact that he didn't have to do that. He could have just nixed us all and started all over again. But he so loved us that he sent part of himself to become a flesh man so that he could live according to the law, fulfill the law, go to the cross as our Savior, go to the cross to pay for our sin, our sickness, and our dis-ease, so that by his stripes we could be made whole, and by the blood that he shed we could be cleansed and made not just accepted, but holy and righteous. We didn't earn a thing. We could have never been good enough to earn it. We could have never been sweet enough to earn it. We could have never been righteous enough. We could have never done things right enough. No, that's how much we're loved. And that's how much he loves the world. That's how much he loves the world. He didn't want anybody. He paid the price for everybody. All we have to do is receive that. Receive that gift. The gift of salvation is a gift. And it's up to us to take that word and take that invitation to everybody we meet and say, let me introduce you to your Savior. Yeah. And what a Savior he is. Oh my. And then you get to enter, once they say yes, you can say, okay, now step into the blessing. Step into the blessing. Wow. It's a wow. That's a wow. Good job, Tylus. Good job. Got to get it out of the way, right? Whoops. Whoops. Wow. That's a wow. Yeah. Well, let's stand to our feet this morning and give him all the praise that he deserves. Amen. He deserves our praise. He deserves our love. He deserves it. And we just want to thank you, thank you, thank you this morning, Lord, because you are righteous, you are holy, and you loved us so very much. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Good night.
Forgiven. accepted, redeemed by His grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise. Cause we were the blood, now the royal seed. We were the blood.
Oh, we greet thee, born this happy morning. Jesus, to thee be all glory give. Word of the Father, now in flesh appearing. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Oh, come, let us adore.
That's why we're here this morning. That's why we're here this morning. We've come to adore you. We've come to tell you thank you. We've come to tell you how much we love you and how much we appreciate you. Thank you for being our shepherd. Thank you for being our healer. Thank you for being our savior. Thank you for being our provider, our protector. Thank you that you are the very breath that we breathe. You're the life that we live. We thank you that you delivered us from death. You delivered us from destruction. Touch your neighbor this morning. Father, I just want to thank you. I want to thank you. That you're the healer, that you're the deliverer. You're our all in all. And I thank you for showing up and showing out this morning. Father, this morning we pray for Sissy. We pray for Holly. Alianda ekembo sambara kiyama sho baradamara and McKinley. Alianda ekembo samba amyanja, as well as all the others that are on our list, Lord. But I'm asking for a special favor this morning. I'm asking that you fill Sissy's house with your precious presence. Bring that peace that passes understanding, that peace that guards the heart and guards the mind. Father, we send forth healing this morning and deliverance this morning to every person in need. Because that's who you are. You are our deliverer. You are our healer. You are our everything. And we believe it, and we receive it, and we say, thank you. Thank you, Lord. And we forgive. We forgive. If we have anything against anybody, Lord, we forgive. We release it now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. I believe you're not going to walk out of here the same as the way you walked in. Amen. That's right. You want to, can we do it after the offering? Okay. Yep. We're going to play Psalm 93 after this. Okay. I mean, Psalm 23. I'm stuck on Psalm 93. Glory to God. What a day. What a day. It is the day that he made. And what are we supposed to do? Rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. There is absolutely no weapon, he said, formed against us that can prosper. So it doesn't make any difference what kind of obstacle is in our way today. It's got to go. It's got to move. Whether it's sickness, whether it's lack, whether it's depression, it doesn't make any difference what it is. It has to go. In the name of Jesus, because at the name of Jesus, every knee must bow.
Plus, they had a men's meeting yesterday and a women's meeting.
Yeah, that's right. Every knee must bow. Every tongue must confess Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. And he will always be Lord. And it will never change. Never change. Isn't that wonderful? That the God that you serve isn't this way today and another way tomorrow. He's not this way right now and another way later. He isn't moody. He isn't moody. He doesn't change his mind. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And if he said it, then you can depend on it. Isn't that awesome? You know anybody else like that? I don't either. How many of you all have ever had somebody promise you that they're going to do something and they don't do it? No, that's exactly right. You don't have enough fingers and toes. And you know what? You can't look at that person and hold that against them. I'll trade it. Thank you, sir. Ma'am. God. That's why it's so wonderful. The God we serve. Because we can always depend on him. All we have to do is not change. All we have to do is stay dynamically strengthened and established to stand immovable in the face of contradictions. Because you will face contradictions. You will face things that say, ain't no way. You see that man? I heard him say, ain't no way. But God. But God. So it makes no difference what people say, what situations say. It doesn't make any difference. God's word never fails. It's what's coming out of your mouth. It's what you're agreeing with. What are you agreeing with? You agree with what they said? Or do you agree with what God said? Amen. Well, this morning, we have an opportunity to prove him. We have an opportunity to prove what he said. He said, prove me with this. If I won't open the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, the word blessing means the empowerment to prosper in every area of your life. So he says, prove me if I won't do this and if I won't rebuke the devourer for your sake. We know who the devourer is. It's Satan. Jesus said in John 10:10, I came that you might have life in abundance to the full till it overflows. But there is one who came to steal, to kill, and destroy. Not me, he said, not me. So as we bring our tithe, what's the tithe? The tenth. I know Ashley was trying to explain that to somebody the other day. You know, tithe isn't used all that often through the Bible. It is in there. But it's the tenth. It's the tenth of everything that we bring into our house during the week. And what you're saying to the Lord is, out here is not my source. My job's not my source. My government's not my source. My husband isn't even my source. My children aren't my source. There's only one, Jesus. He is my source of all things. And so when I present my tithe to him, I'm saying, Lord, I'm declaring to you that you're my source. I'm not looking to the left. I'm not looking to the right. I'm keeping my eyes on you. You're the author and you're the finisher of my faith. And if you said it, you will perform it. It will not return to you void. And then seed. Ooh. Once you get past the 10%, then you start planting seed. And I declare that we're not backyard farm. We're not backyard gardeners. We're farmers. We're farmers. We plant seed wherever we go. You planted seed this morning in your praise. You planted seed this morning as you walked in and you loved on somebody. You planted seed someplace else this morning when you just woke up with a good attitude. Amen? So we're always planting seed, but you can plant financial seed too. And he said, with those seeds, the 11%, then you can start claiming 30, 60, and 100 fold. I'm telling you what, your God wants you to prosper. He wants you to prosper, and he wants you to be in health, even as your soul, your mind, your will, and your emotions prosper. That's awesome. What an awesome God we serve. He didn't want anything from you except your trust and your faith. So, Father, this morning as we bring our tithe, we bring our offerings, we just want you to know how much we love you and the fact that we trust you. You're our God. You're our everything. And we just want to thank you. So take our tithe, open the windows, rebuke the devourer, take our seed and multiply it and give it back to us some 30, 60, and 100 fold in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. If anybody in here didn't get an envelope for their cash or credit card giving, if you can raise your hand, they'll help you. You can also give by Cash App, by Venmo, by PayPal. You can bring your check tonight, 5:30, for more prayer, or Wednesday night at 6:30, or you can mail it, P.O. Box 9868, Chattanooga, Tennessee, 37412. Amen? And you may receive. Father, receive it. Receive it. Can you tell him that? Receive it, Lord. Thank you for opening the windows. In Jesus' name. Psalm 23.
The Lord is my shepherd, there's nothing I need. You lead me to the safest places. You lead me to the safest places. To walk in the meadow and lie by the stream. You meet me in the quiet places. You meet me in the quiet places. Your goodness and your mercy will follow me all the days of my life, all the days of my life. And I'll dwell in your house for eternity. I'll be there by your side, I'll be there.
I love you. Now this morning, here I am. I'm so thankful to be here. All right, we're going to be in 1 John 2:25. We'll try it again. We're in 1 John 2:25. Now, I never will forget that. Never will forget the day God told me to start a church. I said, start a what? Let me tell you something. He said, I want you to build me a house. Let me tell you something. You don't build a house brick by brick. You build a house person by person. You're building in their lives, not in the building lives. So anyway, he said, 1 John 2:25, read them. Wait a minute.
This is the promise that he has promised us. Eternal life.
Stop.
Eternal life. Life.
Now, the whole question is, what is eternal life?
Well, life is the God kind and the God quality of life.
You start winning again. Mm-hmm. In every area of your life.
Amen.
Now, what do you need? Some action.
Yeah.
I need some action in my body.
Yeah.
God raised me from the dead, and I looked around and thought, I can't even move. Then I started moving. He said, now what?
Yeah.
I said, well, I can't talk. He said, you'll talk.
Yeah.
And this is a promise.
Yes, it is a promise.
What do I have to go through anything? I'm going through it now. I go by these good-looking churches, man. And man, they're full. And I got chairs everywhere.
Yep, that are full.
I'm waiting for the what? The increase.
Amen.
Is God the increase?
Yes.
Let me ask you one more time. Is God the increase?
Yes, he is.
Or are we the increase? God's the increase.
God's the increase.
He gives it to us. Gives it to you free, man.
Yep.
That's part of the promise.
That's right. All you got to do is plant the seed, plant the seed, plant the seed.
I don't know how many people in here were broke when they got started, but I was broke. I was in a bar with all these people I was messing around with, and next thing you know, I was an alcoholic, I was a drug addict. I couldn't figure out what I'm going to do. Why? Because I was in debt.
And by the way,
everybody was calling and sending me letters.
Did you hear that? By the way, I was not with him. I was home with the kids. Mm-hmm.
You were still married to me.
I was still married to you, home with the kids.
Okay, did I care? I didn't care about nothing.
Except yourself.
See, care is a man-made quality. God don't care for nothing. Mm-hmm. And you're his kids.
He cares for you.
Roll all of your care upon
him.
Because why?
He cares for me.
That means if you get rid of the care you got, he takes care of it. I couldn't walk, I couldn't talk, I couldn't do nothing. And I got all these people coming, I think, what am I going to do? Well, the first thing I know none of you have ever done this, but the first time I get back to my office by myself, I start crying. Because why? For the first time in a long time, without being liars, I knew I couldn't do it by myself. I need some what?
Help.
Help. That's what you're supposed to say. Help me.
Help me.
I said, and I look up and I said, you know, there's a few people here and thank God for that, but help me. Mm-hmm. Why? People don't come to an empty church. People come where it's hot, baby. Let me tell you something. You're the one he's talking about.
Come on.
Are you hot?
Come on.
Are you hot for God? You're
come
hot.
On. That's right.
You got to care about being hot for God.
That's right.
I don't go sound asleep during prayer. You mean you slept during prayer? I said, everybody sleeps during prayer, man.
Even me. comes to prayer knows that there are times that I fall asleep in prayer.
Now, what time do you start praying?
9 o'clock.
And what time do you end?
When I'm done.
3 years in a row. You know what I do? When I start thinking about my wife, I repent. I'm a good guy. But I repent. Jesus said you get to pray every day, 1 hour. And that was a long time ago. I said, man, I started praying. Man, all my prayer partners were everywhere. All I had to do was get to go to the prayer partner church. And now, there's more prayer needed than ever before.
Oh, man. Yeah.
Your whole world's going to hell.
Uh-huh.
And Satan's trying to get you there. He wants to what? Destroy your church, destroy you, destroy your country, destroy your income, destroy everything.
Yeah.
Until you say one word.
No.
Now my wife, she's just word named hell no.
I say hell no because hell is the one who's trying to do it.
See, hell's a place on the planet.
That's right.
Satan loves it. Why? Because he's in control. When you're not in control of your life, you don't like it.
I'm a citizen of heaven. Hell has no place in my life.
Change your citizenship. As a citizen of the world, no more.
No more.
The citizen of the world was broke all the time.
Uh-huh.
The citizen of the world was woke all the time.
Sick all the time.
Woke, broken.
Sick.
Sick all the time. Well, I tried that stuff. You don't try this, you sell out.
That's it.
I tried from here to the car and walking back and forth, and I couldn't do it. Until one day I said, Lord, I need help. He says, I'm here as your help.
That's right.
Now, have you ever said help before?
Yes.
Say it.
Help!
Now receive it. In other words, if you need it, receive it. The Bible says, believe you receive it and you shall what?
Have it.
I got it now.
I got it.
And it was this week I told Terry, I said, you know something? I said, I'm thankful for a miracle financially because we need one. She said, we'll get one. And we did.
Always. Every time. Every week. Every week. We face the same thing every week, and every week God always
same
answers.
Temptation every week. Until we what? Overcame the temptation. See, when temptation comes, that's Satan. Trying to get you to admit you ain't got enough. I got more than enough.
There's that word, that seduce. He's trying to seduce you.
The word seduce means to tempt you. I love this part. It says the word seduce means to go astray.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you got to go astray from what? What you believe. What do I believe? Every need has been met. Every need in me has been supplied.
That's right. He said that.
My God shall supply
all my need. He said he's given us all things that pertain to this life as well as the life of godliness.
That might mean that some of you might need to get rid of you and receive him.
Mm-hmm. Be renewed in your thinking. Be renewed in your thinking.
And then I started getting more than enough. I thought, thank you. I said, what shall I do with this? I said, give and it shall be.
Given.
One more time, give and it shall be
given.
So I tried it out. No, I didn't. I sold it out. I gave first myself. Mm-hmm. I remember all these people used to come in, man, I thought, wow. Give yourself. Don't worry about me. I'll be all right. Give yourself to God.
Yeah.
And then do one thing that is very hard to do. Let God handle it.
It is hard to do. It's hard to stand in the face of contradiction. It's hard to keep your eyes on Jesus instead of on what's going on around you and all the things that are this little thing that's sitting on your shoulder telling you you're going under, you're going to do this, you're going to do that. It's a lie.
And this is the promise. Watch this. And this is the promise that he has promised you.
Eternal life.
What is eternal life? Eternal on the top only.
Yeah.
How about above only?
Above only, never beneath.
How about never, never being kicked around?
Never.
I said, you mean they'll never kick me around? He said, no, I didn't say that. I said, you'll never be kicked around. You know why? Because I refuse to receive it.
Come on.
You start kicking with your mouth. Amen. That's what I learned. I learned one thing. Your mouth is where the Satan's want, just wants you to say one thing that he's saying. That gives him what authority.
He said, where two of us agree is touching anything. So who are you agreeing with? Are you agreeing with what you see and what you feel? Are you agreeing with your circumstances, or you are agreeing with eternal life?
He said, okay, what did you say, God said? Well, I say you'll have every need supplied.
Every need. That's what he said.
Every need. Who you going to agree with?
I agree.
And I said, I tell you what, when you have a stroke, you think, what should I agree with? I would agree with what? A good speech. A good walk. A good talk.
I agree. I say seven times stronger than what you were before. Because what the enemy
now, what
meant
mean?
For your harm, God, he said what the enemy meant for your harm, God will turn for your good. Yeah. And if you catch a thief, you have to make him pay you sevenfold.
I said, well, Lord, I believe I'm going to be whole. He said, the good, get in the prayer closet every morning.
Because you already are whole.
You start praying every day and pray to the Father. Mm-hmm. Who is what?
In secret.
He's in the hidden place. Guess who wants to open it up? Him. Open up to what? The truth. He is the way, the truth, and the life. We're talking about eternal life. He is it. I said, Lord, I need a new van. He said, you got one. What do you want? I said, I want a new van. The next thing I know, it's $4,400. I said, we had that thing top to bottom, and she drove it. And it's worth driving, wasn't it?
Whole lot of difference. Whole lot of difference.
So how'd you do the $4,400? I still owe it. But I got the van. Who's going to help you? You ain't going to help me. God going to help me. It's God in you. Mm-hmm. Then what you do? Ask and it shall be. Thank you, Lord.
Seek and you'll find.
For helping me.
Thank you. Thank you, Lord, for helping me. Thank you.
You don't believe that, do you? I said, believe it.
Yes, I do.
I believe it so much I received it. Mm-hmm. Now, the Bible says, you can believe, you receive, and you shall. So who's got it? Now am I going to give it away? I can't give it away except with my own mouth. My own will. My own emotion. Isn't it amazing how you say things you never believed you could say when you get mad at somebody? I learned it to say, forgive me. Forgive me. I was doing the best I could, but I was doing bad. Help me to say the right thing. So I said, Lord, help me to say the right thing. Something that you'll listen to. And something that you'll give me the power and strength to overcome.
And he's already done it.
So I got the things that, and this is the promise. He promised you eternal life. That means he's gonna take it over.
You know, the thing is, have we received the eternal life? You know, a lot of people and I know we've said this over and over again, but a lot of people walk in the door of salvation, and they stand in the doorway. When you receive Jesus as your Savior, you just got the promise of eternal life. Life in every, eternal life, God kind, God quality of life in every area of your life. But yet we still put up with, and we get complacent in certain areas. We get used to, oh, well, you know, I'm this way or I'm that way. No, no. We should never get used to anything. If it's not life,
carry
on
preaching. I'm still preaching.
You are. Preach it, buddy.
Do verse 26.
Verse 26. Hang on, let me turn my page. These things I have written to you concerning those who try to deceive you, seduce you, entice
you. Deceive you out of what you got. I got eternal life. That means I'm living right now in the right direction. Am I going to have any trouble? I said, man. I said, God tell me the first time I got born again, I was so happy. I was so excited. And God said, now I tell you, I want you to do one thing for me. I said, okay, good. I want you to go to every woman and ask her for forgiveness. Well, I started counting them. I said, you don't mean that means I want you to go to every woman you know that you've ever, ever done this with. And I want you to ask her forgiveness. So I said, can we do something else, man? And the woman forgive you, but look at me and said, what in the world is wrong with you, man? I said, good morning again. I'm a brand new creature in Christ Jesus. I'm a Christian. And you don't want to. I said, want to. I said, man, I'm learning how to live.
That's it.
That's what I'm finding out about the river of life and all the church we have. They're learning how to live. Mm-hmm. You ain't going to be perfect. He's perfect.
Yep.
He's in you now.
Perfecting me. Yeah.
What's he doing?
Perfecting me.
How?
By correcting me and redirecting me.
Amen.
And protecting me.
What does seduce mean?
Means to entice, to draw away.
So Satan's going to try to what? Entice you. Mm-hmm. Draw you
away
to his way of thinking.
Make something look better or easier. He likes to make you things look better or easier.
I need a keyboard.
We got one.
I got me a key place right here.
We got a keyboard and a piano. You going to play again today?
Yeah, I'm going to play.
Oh, he's going to play again today. See if he got any better. No, he hadn't gotten any better. He hadn't gotten any better, has he?
Do you need somebody to help you? Well, do you hear it?
Yeah.
Does it need help?
Need help. Help.
And God promised me, he said, okay, and I'm going to give you a brand new orchestra. I said, good.
Uh-huh.
How come we ain't got it yet? He said, you ain't there yet. You're still trying to do it yourself. When you roll all the care onto him.
He said, every willing and skillful servant for every manner of service will wholly be at his command.
That's what we said first. He promised me what? Every willing
and skillful servant for every
manner. And
guess
what I found out over the years? There's a lot of people that ain't willing to do nothing. But they keep calling themselves saved. Are you willing to go down to... We went down to community kitchen again the other night. I was so excited. I went by... Teresa, I went by Panera. They gave me how many things of cookies?
We had a lot of cookies, but there were four big boxes of food.
The first thing I did before I went by community kitchen, I said, go through that box.
Yeah.
we unloaded how many boxes?
Four. Big. Really big. Ones I couldn't pick up. I couldn't pick them up.
So we had four or five bags of cookies. I'm looking around. What kind? I said, man, these are chocolate chip with chocolate chips as big as your fist. And they put M&Ms on top. I said, here, we just save one of those cookie pills there. These things have I written unto you concerning them that
try to deceive you,
tempt you,
entice you, tempt you.
Then read one
but,
beautiful scripture for you, verse 22.
But these things I've written to you concerning those who try to deceive you, but the anointing, the burden removing, yoke destroying power which you have received from him abides in you. And you don't need that anybody teach you, but as the same anointing teaches you concerning all things and is true and is not a lie, and just as it has taught you, you will abide.
Now, there's one thing you got to make a decision of. Is the anointing on you now?
Yes.
Why? There's two or three of you gathered together in his name. There he is. Do I have any problems? Here they are. So I started listing them to him. I said, Lord, I'm a preacher. I need a mouth that'll preach. She started preaching. Yeah, he said, send your pulpit. I said, I ain't got no pulpit. It's sitting, not no more. Where them chairs that had people in them? There's people in them now.
That's right.
Now, whether you know it or whether you don't, there's a move of God right now.
Uh-huh.
So the question would be, what are you going to do? Not what am I going to do.
Nope. That's right.
What are you going to do? God is saying you're his kid. That means you are like him. There's one great translation that says you're just like he is.
I am.
So there's one question I got forgotten. What do you want me to do? Many times I want you to go to every hooker you went to. I want you to tell them that you are not that way anymore and tell them you're born again. I said, everyone? He said, every one of them. So I went to the first one. I thought, she said, are you crazy? Are you crazy? That's how the world is going to want to know about you. When you get born again, are you crazy, man? You mean you're looking for good? You got good in you now? No, you don't. You got good on you, in you, and through you.
Yeah.
When I learned that, hey, I came to God so God could work through me.
Yes.
I don't know how many. I don't. I'm laughing because I just don't know how many people we got born again. I have no idea. We're in the 300,000 or 400,000 now. But every time that thing is on, that camera on back there, you're all over the world.
Right.
She had 8,400 listening to her the other night. 8,400.
I said, even if they only listened for a second.
The Word of God is the seed of God. You can put 1 second's all there is.
All it takes is one word from God to change your life forever.
I was broke, and I was broke, but I ain't broke, and I ain't broke.
Thank God.
Here's this chapter 3, evidences of true believers. That we have no poverty. See, you're a child of God. You have no poverty at all. unless you what? Receive it. Not yours.
You might have the temptation. It's just like, it's like what he's explaining is eternal life is perfect. Guess who's not? But on the inside, we are. Our spirit man, when you get born again, your spirit man gets born again. You're bringing all this other stuff in line with your spirit. But you have to teach it. And so when poverty comes knocking at your door, you can either open the door and welcome it in. Same thing with sickness and disease. Same thing with strife and division. Anything that doesn't, that is anti-Christ, anti-anointing, anti-life, is going to come knocking at your door. But you have the choice. You can open the door and say, well, come on in. Or you can slam the door and lock it and say, no, 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 you are not welcome here. I plead the blood. The blood of Jesus cleansed you from all unrighteousness.
When you received Jesus the first time, he took the scale off your eyes. You couldn't see before, but then you can. The veil is gone.
This life is a fight. A fight for life. A fight for life. You know, some people who we know have gotten death sentences from the doctors. The doctors have given them death sentences. And you either have to fight or you give in.
And I say, if you don't remember anything, remember this. Like father, like son.
Oh, yeah. That's right. Like father, like son.
Remember.
Chip off the old block. You're a chip off the old block.
Jesus is all about what? Don't get mad now. Jesus is all about change.
Change.
If you're broke today, change. If you can't pay your bills, you mean you don't want change?
We were there. We were there. All of us go through. You're going through the natural life. But you fight the natural life with the eternal life. You fight the circumstances with the Word of God that never changes. You fight the circumstances you face with the promises of God that are all yes and so be it or amen unto you. That's how you fight. You fight the good fight of faith.
Now look at chapter 3. Father and son. Father has bestowed upon you. What?
He says, behold what manner of love the Father has bestowed on us, that we should be called children of God. Therefore, the world doesn't know us because it didn't know him.
World don't even know you. Just like them hookers I used to mess with. They didn't know me. Why? Because I'm brand new. But I was doing a brand new thing, too.
Right.
But there wasn't nobody. It ain't happened to me. Me. I was so happy. I mean, I knew every bartender, every place I went. I knew every one that around, and I was worn out.
I think I was happier than you were.
And when he actually came and took it off me,
delivered you. He delivered you
and gave me a new life.
Thank God.
I was so excited. I don't care if you're sick. I don't care if you're limping. I don't care if your inside are messed up. I don't care about nothing. God gives you something brand new.
Yeah.
I go through the prison up in Warburg all the time. I go through the prison. The first thing I do when I enter the gate, they go, hey, brand new. I see you. Hey, brand new. You got it.
That's right.
Can I say one thing? Don't get mad. I can't believe Christians are ashamed of God anyway. Get around people that don't know God, you're ashamed of God. He set you free.
Oh, man.
And healed you no matter what.
Yes.
I said no matter what.
No matter what.
You know, I saw this the other day. You know, people have a pain and they think it's wrong. You overcome pain. That's what it's all about. How do you think Satan's knocking? He's knocking pain on you to get you to say, yeah, yeah. I say, nay, nay.
Yeah. You know, I was watching, how many of y'all have watched the Easter service that I posted online from 1993? Nobody? Some of you. Okay. You know, in one part, they've got Jesus on the cross. It was for Easter. And one lady walked up to him and said, I thought you were the healer. My mama died. You're just a liar. Let me ask you something. If you die and go to heaven, are you healed? The only part of you that can die is this flesh. Whether you go to heaven or whether you go to hell, the only part of you that can die is your flesh. The rest of you lives forever. So you have a choice. You're going to live forever in heaven or you're going to live forever in hell. See, I don't think people get a grip on that. Let me promise you, God's not a liar. It's just sometimes we don't get it. Sometimes we don't get it. Sometimes, I mean, if you saw heaven like he saw heaven, you would never get mad at God for letting somebody come home. I've had people beg, Jesus, please let me come home. I'm ready. I'm done here. I want out. Heaven is perfect. Do you know that there's not even a shadow in heaven? There's no need for electricity because it's always light. There's no sickness. There's no disease. There's no lack. There's no strife. There's no poverty. There's no divisions. There's no prejudice. There's no nothing. Nothing. It's perfect. Now you can go to hell where you've got everything bad. And you get it all at one time. With no reprieve. You don't get a break. You don't get a holiday. You don't get a vacation from hell. Hell is forever. Or you can live in heaven forever. I mean, really. I mean, you and I think about that. We can look at that and go, why would anybody ever want to choose hell? Yet we chose hell all the time. Until we saw. It's just like what Pastor Hittigay said when he was here. And he said, you can either live in the mystery or you can live in the misery. See, until you get born again, you don't even have eyes to see the difference. You can't tell the difference. I mean, even though you might be unhappy before you get born again, with your lifestyle, with this and that, you still really can't tell the difference between life and death. You just think, this is life. This is just life. When you get born again, you gain the understanding of the mystery that Jesus came to set us free. He came and bought and paid for our life so that we could have life in abundance to the full until it overflows.
That's why I give you vision.
Yeah.
Not what you can see, but vision.
That's right.
It's inside.
You know, it's just like you brought up vision this morning, and I was listening last night. Rick Renner was talking about vision, and he was saying, how do you enter into 2024 strong? What's your vision? What has God dropped in your heart? I know what's been in our heart for 35 years plus. Alan Kreider, take heed. River of Life, take heed. I've chosen you. Pay attention. I've chosen you to build a house for the sanctuary. I've chosen you to obtain children for my family. I've chosen you to build me a family. And you do that through the gift of salvation. And each and every one of us have a part in that. Every single one of us has an important part in building that family.
Every new building I go by, I say one thing. I say, Lord, look at that building. Somebody built it.
You know, I
got a warehouse.
And I look back at Azusa Street. You know where Azusa Street started? In a barn. They had church in a barn. They sat on hay bales, and the Holy Ghost was so strong that the kids played hide and seek in the glory cloud. It ain't about this building, it's about this building. We got to build this building to where, you said it, we got to be so hot for God that nothing can stop us. We start wildfires wherever we go because we're so hot for God. And I can't do that for you. He can't do that for you. We can preach and encourage you, but you have to seek His face.
Now I'm hearing words like, when y'all first got started, y'all were hot. Man, we're hot now.
We are hot. I think you're exactly right. I think we're hotter. I think Alan and I are hotter. You all might not be, but I am. He is. I tell you what. You're not going to stop us. If we weren't hotter, we would have quit. Listen, all of us, yeah, we'd be in Florida on the beach, folks. I'd be picking up, what do you call them? Shark's teeth. Now, seashells aren't as fun as the shark's teeth. But I'd do that too. I just want to encourage you as we enter into this last month of the year. Search your heart. Search your heart. What can you do better? Where has complacency set in? Where have you just kind of said, well, that's just the way it is? No, that's not the way it is. We got to press for that eternal life. Press, because we have the anointing to destroy every yoke and remove every burden. He said, no weapon, none, formed against us shall prosper. Any tongue that should rise up in judgment against us, we have to condemn. We have to say no, no, no. And He'll show it to be wrong. So we're in a great challenge. A great challenge to rise up to a new level.
Take long enough to let Him get a shot at telling you and showing you how He does it. Because He's already condemned it.
Yep, it's a new day. It's a new day. Ooh, and He said, I'm doing a new thing. Are you going to know it? Are you going to be awake enough to see it? I say, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. So can we make this confession of faith today? Lord Jesus, I call You my Savior. I declare that You died for my sins, for my sickness, for my disease, and You made me whole by Your stripes. I receive the precious Holy Spirit to abide in me in power, to empower me to live this life. I believe it. I receive it. I'm a born-again child of God. I am a Holy Ghost-filled, tongue-talking person. That's who I am. And I'm going to see this city one for Jesus. Every person I meet is going to hear about what a love we serve. He is a love that we serve. So, put on the whole armor of God. The helmet of salvation. The breastplate of righteousness. My loins are girt about with truth. My feet are shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Oh, I have the shield of faith. When fear knocks, my faith answers. And I carry the sword of the Spirit, the word of the living God, which slices and dices the enemy in Jesus' name. Now, Father, I station angels of the Lord to encamp round about each and every one till we meet again tonight at 5:30 for prayer. Because we can't build this house without prayer and evangelism. So come pray and go out and evangelize. All you got to do is be you. That's what evangelism is. Be you. Be you. Let people see Jesus in you. Bye. In the name of Jesus, I want to thank you. Our announcements, announcements. You took my sheet. Where'd you put my sheet? There was a sheet. You sitting on it? You were? Oh, well. My sheet is up here. It was there. Stand up, Papa. Well, let's straighten that out just a little bit. Glory to God. I think it's this Tuesday night at Purpose Church. Is it this Tuesday or next Tuesday? So that's next week. Okay, next Tuesday at, Is it this coming Tuesday at Purpose Church? Mark Hankins is this week. All right, I'm sorry, I lost my dates. Because that one's not on here. Yeah, prayer, they're having prayer at Purpose Church, which is at, that's Tom and Tiki Finlayson's church at Boy Scout Road. Yeah, it's at Boy Scout Road and Middle Valley Road. It's right in through there. And they're having prayer at 7 o'clock for Mark Hankins, who will be here Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Is that correct? Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Okay. So he'll be at Living Faith, which is on Cassandra Smith. Okay? At 7 o'clock. And then they're having meetings in the morning. Yes. I'll post it online. Okay? And I'll make sure that I get it on. I'll get all of it right tonight. I'm doing good. All right. Holiday services, don't forget Christmas Eve, we will have our 10 a.m. and then our that evening service will be a candlelight service, and that will be at 7 o'clock. You don't want to miss that. That's so precious. It's the way we usher in the Christmas season. It's beautiful. And then, of course, New Year's Eve, we'll have Sunday a.m. at 10, and then that evening we'll do our 5:30. And you don't want to miss that one either, because we'll have different people come and give us what they're hearing from the Lord about 2024. Amen. Panera Bread Pickup. If you can help with Panera Bread Pickup, even if it's just one day a week, we pick up on Wednesday nights at 8 o'clock at Panera in Fordo and take it to the community kitchen. Yeah, if you can even do it one day a month, one time a month, that would be great. But see Teresa. Teresa, wave your hand. And EGOM is on their last leg of getting their house ready to open. And so if you can help, they still owe $22,000, I think, which is nothing. And then we need to get them a budget to get them open and started. Amen? Glory to God. I'm excited about that. Really excited, because they've taken it from the prayer closet and they've put it into action. And they're going to touch lives. They're going to touch women's lives. Amen? Make a major change. Am I missing anything? Oh, December. I don't have them. All right, if you've got a birthday in December, stand to your feet. Or a Glenda Beard, when is it? Next Sunday, which is the 10th. The 16th is Rita. Sally is the 26th, 23rd, 29th. Anybody else got an anniversary? Uh-uh, you guys stand up. Stand up. Who's got an anniversary? Whose? Gracie's was yesterday. Yeah. And Anita, your birthday was yesterday too. That's right. Aha. Anybody else got a birthday before I miss? Nobody's got an anniversary? Okay. You ready? Now, for those of you all who are new here, we sing as loud and as off key as we can so that they don't ever forget it. Amen. Happy birthday, everybody. I love you. We're going to have a great year. Amen. Those of us who are, what would we call them, old codgers, we just say, hey, I'm just middle-aged. That's right. That's right. That's right, because 100, well, I'm a little bit more than middle-aged if I'm going to live to be 120. Anyway, I'm like a good wine. I just get better and better and better. Amen? All right. I love y'all. See you tonight at 5:30. Call you blessed.